Hello. In this video, we'll see an overview of the Lance Design interface. We will start by launching Lance Design through a Lance Design template. We'll go over a quick overview of the main toolbars. We will analyze the Edit panel, the most important dialog of the program, from where we will be able to edit the document properties, set the layer configuration by object types, navigate over the different representation modes of the Lance Design elements in 2D and 3D, and see how to add them from the Properties area in the dialog. We'll see how to do this also from the Properties Explorer dialog, how to find the different commands from the menu and contextual menu, and finally, we'll see how to find help for the Lance Design plugin. After having installed Lance Design, we'll see the icon created on our desktop, from which we can launch Lance Design. Go ahead and double-click on it, select which unit system you want to use. This will open a design template once you click on OK. Just go ahead and skip these messages all the way till the last one. We have now opened Lance Design using one of its integrated templates. We could also open Rhino using the Rhino desktop shortcut or by double-clicking on a 3DM file. In those cases, Lance Design will load as soon as we run any of its commands. You can then use a Lance Design template by going to File Menu, New, select the Lance Design folder, and choose any of these templates. Now, let's go over the main toolbars. The first long toolbar contains all of the Lance Design commands. We then have the same commands distributed into three different tabs organized by topics. So here we'll find all the commands that allow us to insert vegetation elements. We can insert them individually, from points, or in paint mode. We can insert plan rows, forest, shrubs, ground covers. Here we can find the hardscape tools that allow us to insert walls, fences, stairs, paths, or rows of objects that we can also find in the Block Explorer. And here, under the Terrain icon, we can find all the terrain modeling commands. In the Lance Documentation tab, we can find the Irrigation tools, Listing and Plan Level commands, Plan, Photo, Level, Dimension, Slope, Zonify commands, or plan shadows. Finally, in the Lance tab, we can find other commands. For example, the one that opens the Edit panel, that is already open here, by the way. The one that opens the Animation panel, or some additional commands to open the plant database. Use an image filter application to apply some effects on existing images. Set viewpoints or navigate interactively through your project with a walk mode. If you close the set of toolbars accidentally, or they're no longer visible, you can always recover them by going to the Tools menu, Toolbar Layout, select Lance Design, and then check the toolbars you want to make visible. I'll select these four tabs back. To show you another way, let's close the toolbars again. Then right-click in the gray area under the toolbars, select Show Toolbar, then scroll down until we find the Lance Design section. Now I'll dock the toolbar group at the top in order to clear the viewport area. Let's take a look at the Lance Design Edit panel, which is one of the main tools. It will allow us to change the document properties, as well as editing the objects we select in the scene. As you can see, it's divided into three sections. In the top part, we can see the objects in the scene. On the right, we'll have a list of edit commands available for the selection. In the bottom section, we can access the object properties, or the document properties in the case where nothing is selected. Under the document properties, we can select how we want to manage the new objects we create and in which layers they'll be inserted. For example, for plants, if we click on this icon, we can choose in which one of the existing layers the plant will be placed. It'll then be located in that layer. However, if we click on the cross and leave the default options, the plant will be generated in a new layer that will be created as soon as we insert it. We can modify that by going to the Lens Design menu, Options, Layers, and here we can define the name and the color of this new layer. Now, under the Geolocation tab, we can define drawing coordinates according to a latitude, longitude, and elevation. The values are in reference to the zero-point coordinate of the plane. In the Render tab, we can decide if the vegetation elements will be rendered as seen in the drawing, or if they will be replaced by a very detailed plant. Under the Document tab, we can switch between the 2D and 3D display of plants. Let's insert a plant to better understand the different representation modes for this object type. I'll run the plant command. I select a plant from the plant database. Insert it in the model. We can see the plant now in realistic representation. From here, we can switch to elevation, conceptual, detailed, and realistic. Using the slider below, we can switch from a 3D view to billboard. It's a surface with an image mapped that gets oriented towards the camera. Let's go back to the 3D view of the plant. In the document properties, we can also select the document season. It will determine the appearance of that plant when rendered. With some species, the appearance can also change in the preview. For example, if we select winter, the plant will be displayed with a different representation. We can quickly switch from 3D to a 2D representation by clicking on these buttons. The elements that handle different representations will adjust back and forth. From this dialog, we can select objects by type. We can enable the automatic projection of elements on terrains, if we have any, and the automatic update of objects that require some modifications. In this listing area, we can see the list of different species and the amount of units we have for each one. If we select an object, we will see the edit commands available for the selected object. Under the Properties area, we can navigate over these tabs to modify the properties of the object. For example, the head. Another way to modify the properties of an object is from the Properties Explorer. Open it by simply double-clicking on the object. Here we'll find the same properties as found under the Lens Edit panel. Take into account that all Lens Design commands are also available from the menu. Another way of accessing these commands is through the contextual menu. If you right-click the object and hold until this icon appears, the contextual menu will pop up with many of the edit options. If you have any doubts or questions on a Lens Design command, you can go to the Lens Design menu, Help, and access the help file. I'll delete this tree. We're now ready to start using Lens Design on a new project. Thank you for watching!